layers of the atmosphere. The Earth's atmosphere is the layers of the gases which protects the Earth from the radiations and cosmic rays coming from the outer space. This atmosphere acts as a blanket because it keeps the average temperature of the Earth nearly constant. Earth's atmosphere can be divided into five main layers. These layers are the troposphere, the stratosphere, the mesosphere, the thermosphere, and the exosphere. The troposphere. Tropos means change. This layer gets its name from the weather that is constantly changing and mixing up the gases in this part of our atmosphere. This layer is the closest to Earth's surface. On average, the troposphere extends from the ground to about 12 kilometers or 7.5 miles high. The troposphere contains about 75% of all of the air in the atmosphere and almost all of the water vapor, which forms clouds and rain. In this layer, air is made up of approximately 78% nitrogen, 21% oxygen, and 1% argon, with small amounts of additional gases, including water vapor and carbon dioxide. Hot air balloons fly within the troposphere. The stratosphere. Strat means layer. This layer of our atmosphere has its own set of layers. The boundary between the stratosphere and the troposphere is called the tropopause. It is the region where airplanes fly. The stratosphere layer extends from the tropopause to about 50 kilometers or 32 miles above the Earth's surface. This layer contains a thin layer of ozone molecules, which forms a protective layer and absorbs harmful ultraviolet radiation from the sun. The high-altitude weather balloons flying into the stratosphere for monitoring atmospheric conditions and climate research. The mesosphere. Meso means middle. This layer is located above the stratosphere and below the thermosphere. It is the third layer in our atmosphere, which is 35 kilometers or 22 miles thick. The transition boundary, which separates the mesosphere from the stratosphere, is called the stratopause. in the mesosphere, fewer air molecules to absorb incoming electromagnetic radiation from the sun. Most meteors burn up in this atmospheric layer. A meteor is a piece of rock or matter that has been broken off in space and travels through the atmosphere. When they cross the mesosphere, friction and momentum cause the meteor to burn up and appear as a light crossing the sky. The thermosphere. Thermo means heat. This layer has extremely high temperatures and located above the mesosphere and below the exosphere. The boundary between the mesosphere and the thermosphere atmospheric regions is called mesopause. It is the coldest part of Earth's atmosphere. The thermosphere extends from the mesopause to 700 kilometers of 435 miles above the surface of the Earth. The thermosphere is the thickest layer in the atmosphere. Only the lightest gases, mostly oxygen, helium, and hydrogen, are found here. The aurora and satellites mostly occur in this layer. An aurora is a natural light display in the sky, particularly in the high latitude regions, that is caused by the collision of energetic charged particles with atoms in the high altitude atmosphere. The exosphere. Exo means outside. The exosphere represents the outermost layer of Earth's atmosphere. It extends from the top of the thermosphere to 10,000 kilometers or 6,214 miles above Earth's surface. In this layer, atoms and molecules escape into space, and higher altitude satellites orbit our planet. Temperature versus height. Near the surface of the Earth, the average temperature is 15 degrees Celsius, and the temperature gradually decreases to minus 56 degrees Celsius as altitude increases. Then the temperature remains constant below ozone layer. In the stratosphere region, from the ozone layer the temperature progressively increases to negative 2 degrees Celsius. Then, the temperature ranges from negative 2 degrees Celsius to negative 92 degrees Celsius at the upper boundary of mesosphere. After then, the temperature rises from negative 92 degrees Celsius to 1,200 degrees Celsius near the upper boundary of thermosphere. Why it happens. During the day, a portion of the incoming of the radiant energy from the sun passes through the atmosphere, is absorbed and warms the Earth's surface. Then, the heat's reflected back from the ground to the tropospheric air by conduction and convection process. The temperature in the troposphere gradually decreases with increasing altitude until the tropopause is reached. The stratosphere is very dry, and clouds are rare. As we know, ozone is concentrated in this part of the atmosphere. This ozone absorbs shortwave ultraviolet radiation from the sun and converts them into heat. More radiation is absorbed at higher altitudes compared to the lower stratosphere, so the temperature increases with height. The mesosphere has the coldest temperatures in the atmosphere. It becomes cold enough to freeze water vapor in its atmosphere into ice clouds. The air density in the mesosphere is low than in the stratosphere below. Due to less air particles, not enough heat is absorbed, which eventually leads to a colder temperature. Apart from that, carbon dioxide in the mesosphere also helps in making this layer cold due to its cooling effect. Carbon dioxide molecules absorb heat energy when they bounce off other molecules. The carbon dioxide releases some of that energy as photons in a process called radiative emission. Some of those photons travel upwards, carrying heat away from the mesosphere. Thus, temperature in the mesosphere keeps dropping with increase in altitude until it reaches about minus 100 degrees Celsius. The thermosphere has extremely high temperatures. Within the thermosphere, temperatures rise continually to well beyond 1000 degrees Celsius. The source of the thermosphere's heat is radiation emitted by the sun. The thermosphere absorbs much of the radiation that Earth receives from the sun, leaving only a fraction to actually reach the surface. Ultraviolet radiation, visible light, and high-energy gamma radiation are all absorbed by the thermosphere. Since there is little to no atmospheric gases above the thermosphere, there is no absorption of the heat from solar radiation, and so temperatures soar. The exosphere is almost a vacuum. The air is very, very thin air. When air is thin, it doesn't transfer much heat to objects in the air, even if the air is very, very hot. The temperature in the exosphere varies greatly and can range from 0 to over 1700 degrees Celsius. It is colder at night and much hotter during the day. If you enjoyed this video, then make sure you subscribe and hit the notifications bell so you don't miss a single video.